Please be seated. I extend to you all a very warm welcome to St. Peter's Cathedral this evening, as we give thanks for the life of Her Late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. I welcome those who are gathered outside and those who are participating at home through the live stream. I now invite Uncle Major Moogie Sumner to welcome us to country.
Before we start, I'd like to invite our ancestors to be with us. My ancestors, your ancestors, Mary and Mama, invite them in. Come here and sit down with us here. And walk with us to be a part of the ceremony. The song was to welcome you and your ancestors here to this land. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to do a smoking ceremony to take away any negative energy that comes with us as we travel across the land. Wherever we go, we don't know what happens. There's negative energy that will attach itself to us wherever we go. We take it with us. We take it to work. We take it home. Ask our ancestors to take that away.
Mm-hmm. her journey back home to her ancestors. Help her spirit to connect with them. What I'd like to do is thank people for inviting me in to do this ceremony. On behalf of my mother's people, once again, I welcome all to the land of the time. You and your ancestors. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Uncle. In gratitude, we come together to mourn a greatly loved Queen. Together, we give thanks to Almighty God for the duty our late Queen Elizabeth II rendered to our homeland, Australia, her other realms and territories, and to the Commonwealth of Nations. As we commend our late Queen Elizabeth, his servant, to God's mercy, let us especially remember and pray for her son, King Charles, her grandson, William, Prince of Wales, and all her family in their loss. We give them back to thee, dear Lord, who gavest them to us. Yet as thou didst not lose them in giving, so we have not lost them by their return. Not as the world giveth, givest thou, O lover of souls. What thou gavest, they takest not away. For what is thine is ours, also if we are thine. And life is eternal, and love is immortal, and death is only an horizon, and an horizon is nothing save the limit of our sight. Lift us up, strong Son of God, that we may see further. Cleanse our eyes, that we may see more clearly, and draw us closer to thyself, that we may know ourselves to be nearer to our loved ones who are with thee. And while thou dost prepare a place for us, prepare us also for that happy place, that where they are and thou art, we too may be forevermore.
Thank you. ones will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seemed to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth, and they will run like sparks through the rubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Oh, A reading from the Revelation of St. John the Divine. After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honour and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal, and they have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Hear the word of the Lord.
Thank you. name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Would you please be seated? It's a great privilege to add my welcome to this Thanksgiving service for Her late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. It's a great privilege for us to be able to host the service. I want to thank the Dean of the Cathedral, Bishop Chris McLeod, and the Cathedral staff for the arrangements for this evening's service, and the Cathedral Choir for assisting us in our worship. As we gather this evening, we come to do a number of things. First, we come to acknowledge, to pay our respects to Her late Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. Even though she was based in England, she was our Queen, and she served faithfully for more than 70 years. She visited South Australia 7 times and worshipped in this cathedral on 4 occasions. There were many crises at home and abroad during her 70-year reign, and many personal challenges. Yet through it all, she carried out her duty faithfully and well, without ego, serving right to the end of her long life. Upon hearing of the death of her father, King George VI, the young Queen spoke bravely from South Africa in the midst of her sadness and said, "I declare before you all that my whole life, whether it be long or short, shall be devoted to your service and the service of our great imperial family to which we all belong." The imperial family has certainly changed since 1952. But today we celebrate the fact that Her Majesty fulfilled that vow in a joyful, faithful, and generous way, undertaking more than 21,000 engagements during her reign, with the last 2 engagements just days before her death. The second thing we come to do is express our sadness at her death. While we all knew she was growing older and more frail, Her late Majesty's quite sudden death, I think, caught us by surprise. Many will feel sad that she is no longer our Queen. As she grew older, Her late Majesty became more like our grandmother or great-grandmother, and we will miss that rock, that familiar and unchanging part of our lives. For most of us, Queen Elizabeth is the only monarch we've ever known. Her photograph was in schools, halls, and community clubs all around the country, and her silhouette on stamps, coins, and banknotes. Many of us grew up singing "God Save Our Gracious Queen" at school every morning. I have to say, I found it quite jarring to hear "God Save the King" at the proclamation of King Charles III's accession at North Terrace just over a week ago. Queen Elizabeth might have lived a long way away, but she was always there, part of the life of our nation and state. And in an uncertain time, a rock of certainty and stability. And we will miss her. The third thing we come to do is thank God for the life and service of Queen Elizabeth II. In her first Christmas address, Queen Elizabeth II, as she looked forward to her coronation in 6 months' time, said this: "I want to ask you all, whatever your religion may be, to pray for me on that day, to pray that God may give me wisdom and strength to carry out the solemn promises I shall be making, and that I may faithfully serve him and you all the days of my life." Today, we gather both inside and outside the cathedral to thank God for entering those prayers and to give thanks to God for the life and service of the Queen. When her father died, the proclamation of Queen Elizabeth's accession to the throne included these words: "That the high and mighty Princess Elizabeth Alexandra Mary is now, by the death of our late sovereign of happy memory, become Queen Elizabeth II by the grace of God." A significant phrase in the proclamation is, "by the grace of God." The understanding of the authors of the proclamation is that the monarch reigned with the permission of God, the ultimate ruler of the heavens and the earth, as an expression of God's love for all creation. That's what grace means. Grace is undeserved love or favour. The words of the proclamation of the new queen had as their foundation the understanding that she reigned under the reign of God, and that her reign was a gift of love from God. Her reign was part of God's good and loving plan for the good order and flourishing of the world. So today we thank God for God's love expressed in the life and service of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. We thank God for the gift of Elizabeth, for her faithfulness to her people and her devotion to her role that she saw as a lifelong vocation from God. We thank God for giving Queen Elizabeth the strength she needed for what was a very difficult task. The fourth thing we do this evening is to commend Queen Elizabeth to the mercy and love of God. And we can do that with confidence because of God's love for her and her response of trust and faith in God. The Christian faith of Her Late Majesty was absolutely clear. In her Christmas message of 2000, the Queen said, "To many of us, our beliefs are of fundamental importance. For me, the teachings of Christ and my own personal accountability before God provide a framework in which I try to lead my life." And last Christmas, in her message, the Queen said this of Jesus, "A man whose teachings have been handed down from generation to generation and have been the bedrock of my faith." It's important to remember that the faithful service for which we are so thankful and the character which we admire had its foundation and basis in the Christian faith of the Queen. That faith was the motivation for and framework of her life. Her Majesty was not perfect, as none of us is perfect. But ultimately, it's not our perfection that counts. The Christian faith says what counts is what God has done for us in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. There is found forgiveness and relationship with God now and forever. Our response to God's love is to trust in Jesus' death and resurrection. Her Late Majesty did that through her whole life. And so we can be confident that she now rests in peace and will rise in glory to eternal life. The fifth thing we do this evening is to pray for King Charles and his family in their grief. It must be very, very tough to grieve in public, as the royal family have had to do over the past 10 days. Every action, every step, every word, or even every look scrutinised without mercy. The funeral is over now, but the sadness and loss will continue. We pray for them and for God's peace for their lives. At the end of tonight's service, we will sing part of a very well-known hymn, and its words include, "God Save the King." Those words are a reminder to us to pray for King Charles III. I doubt anyone would want the job he has now inherited. Following his enormously popular mother will not be easy, and yet his success is important for us all. So we do pray God's blessing for our King, Charles III. May his reign be marked by faithfulness, wisdom, grace, and peace. Queen Elizabeth II has given great service as our Queen, and we celebrate that gift. As we remember her and reflect on her life, may we do more than just receive the gift. May we be encouraged to follow her example of selfless service for the good of others, strengthened and guided by God, who loves us all. Amen.
In faith, let us pray to our risen Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and life of all who trust in him. Remembering before him our late Sovereign Elizabeth, Queen of Australia, whom we now recall in a moment of silent prayer. God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you humble thanks that by his death he destroyed the power of death, and by his glorious resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Grant us to know that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life, nor things present nor things to come, shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously, we pray, with all those who mourn, that casting all their care on you, they may know the consolation of your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly pray you to bless our most gracious sovereign, King Charles, Camilla, Queen Consort, William, Prince of Wales, and all the royal family. Endue them with your Holy Spirit. Enrich them with your heavenly grace. Prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to your everlasting kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Eternal Lord God, you hold all souls in life. Shed forth, we pray, upon your whole church, in paradise and on earth, the bright beams of your light and heavenly comfort. And grant that we, following the good example of our late Queen Elizabeth, and those who have loved and served you here and are now at rest, may at the last enter with them into the fullness of your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we bless your holy name for all that you have given us in and through the life of your daughter Elizabeth, our late Queen. We give you thanks for her love of family and her gift of friendship, for her grace, dignity, and courtesy, for her humour, generosity, and sheer love of life. And we praise you for the courage that she showed in times of hardship, the depth and reality of her Christian faith, the good example that she set for us to follow. Amen.
We offer you our heartfelt thanks for the deep affection she drew out of everyone she met. And we pray that you will grant her peace. Let light perpetual shine upon her. and in your loving wisdom and almighty power, work in her the good purpose of your perfect will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Let us commend our sister Elizabeth, our late Queen, to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. O Heavenly Father, by your mighty power you have given us life, and in your love you have given us new life in your beloved Son. We entrust our sister Elizabeth to your merciful keeping, in the faith of the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. May God, in his infinite love and mercy, bring the whole church, living and departed in the Lord Jesus, to a joyful resurrection and the fulfilment of his eternal kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen.